You're watching Capital View, Sunday morning talk focused on the political scene in Arkansas.
And welcome back to the program. We are here for some analysis on the governor's debate and other political topics from this last week. I have Representative Megan Godfrey, Democrat of Springdale, with us. I have GOP political strategist Bill Vickery with me of the great state of Crawford County.
Exactly.
Van Buren. Got to work all that in there. Hey, my PA Bruins whooped up on your
they
Van Buren.
They did. It was an embarrassment.
It was. So I'm glad we didn't put any money on that game for your sake.
Let that go for the pointers.
All right. The governor's debate on Friday between Sarah Huckabee Sanders, the GOP nominee, Chris Jones, the Democratic nominee, Libertarian Ricky Dale Harrington. Bill, I will come to you first on this.
Uh-huh.
What did each candidate need to accomplish? Did they accomplish it?
Well, I think the race is a foregone conclusion at this point. Sarah Huckabee Sanders is going to win. She's going to be governor. I feel like for her, no one can say anymore that there are no specifics to any plans. I mean, she went into excruciating detail on a lot of different things and took up basically her whole time outlining a lot of different plans. And so I think that's what she wanted to do. She wanted to tell the public what she's going to do once she's in office, and I think she accomplished that.
She's had 22 months to do that, I just point out. Megan, what do you think in terms of what Chris Jones had to do as the Democratic nominee? Did he accomplish what he needed to?
Sure, I think Chris needed to communicate that he has the momentum, that he has a lot of excitement, a lot of enthusiasm behind him, and I think that he went into the debate with that enthusiasm behind him. I think that he had a positive and a hopeful message. He communicated clearly and concisely, and I think that Sarah really kind of responded to that. I think, yes, maybe Bill, you know, is saying that she's the foregone conclusion, but I'm not sure she acted like that today. I think actually she was responding to Chris's momentum and seeing that she's had to make a few adjustments to her message to be more resonant with voters that perhaps she thought she had locked up, and instead is seeing that Chris really is moving forward in a way that is perhaps surprising to her and to others across the state.
No, again, it's a foregone conclusion. I mean, if we want to put money on anything, you'll put money on the fact that Sarah Huckabee Sanders is going to be the next governor. And during that 22 months that you referenced, she raised more money than any gubernatorial candidate in history. I think she's going to win by the widest margin of any gubernatorial candidate in history. And so she has communicated, I think, as she noted today, with, you know, thousands and thousands of Arkansans on a regular basis. I like the fact that she said she talks to people directly, doesn't worry about the media, doesn't worry about her message being misconstrued, goes directly to them. And I think the result on Election Day is going to be the manifestation of all this campaigning up to that point.
Yeah, go ahead.
Well, I actually thought she felt a little bit defensive about that. I felt like she really needed to prove that she was indeed communicating with voters across the state. Chris Jones has been very out front, very available, very accessible, and people are starting to hear that message and really connect with it. And I think Sarah felt a little bit like she needed to prove that she too, you know, lives in Arkansas and visits Arkansas and communicates with Arkansans in a way that felt a little bit defensive, while Chris has been so strong on that front.
Let's move to another part of what I think is debate strategy, and that is when you're on a stage like that, it is the only stage that you're going to have in terms of being, I guess, on the stage together and doing some sort of compare and contrast. One of the things that you, and I'm sure you advise political candidates on this, I'm sure you as a political candidate have thought about this, you don't want to make any mistakes. Did they both avoid making mistakes today?
I did think it was there was a casual sense to what was going on. I think the Libertarian candidate happened to add to that as well. I didn't sense that any candidate made a mistake necessarily. And two, I did feel it was, laid back's not the right word, but there was a casualness to the whole thing. I didn't feel like it was any kind of tension convention, and I think that's because these guys have been out campaigning for a long time. We're doing this sort of wrap everything up.
Yeah, they were both comfortable. Did you feel like that the candidates also did not make any major stumbles?
You know, one thing I would want to know is I noticed that Sarah said that she was going to be fighting against good policy. I assume that was a mistake, but I'm not sure that it was. That was something that I noticed that hit a little bit peculiar as she said it. But I do agree with Bill that ultimately it was a very kind of measured and professional debate. I thought they came with their plans and their vision and communicated just kind of in a way that didn't have a lot of fireworks. That's kind of how people have been describing the debate. And I would say that's because there weren't a lot of stumbles or fumbles or missteps by the candidates.
As we were talking, it was the classic public television debate. It was quiet and mild-mannered, and I thought the questions were good, and so I think that came across in the production.
Yeah, I did think the questions were good. I thought there were some very well-timed questions there, too. And on Ricky Dale Harrington, the Libertarian candidate there, his mission is to get to 3% so that the Libertarians qualify as a political party.
Yeah.
I was with somebody watching that debate, and they said, I want him to speak at my funeral. He's such a smooth talker there. So maybe assess a little bit of his performance. Do you think that he did enough to get the Libertarians where they needed to get? Megan?
You know, I was impressed by his performance, just in his demeanor and the way he came prepared, both kind of with that big picture, what his leadership style is and will be, and also on some particular policies. I thought he had some great answers to some of the specific questions. Whether or not it's enough to get to 3%, I'm not sure, but I do think that his presence was welcome in the debate, and I actually thought that some of the things he was saying, both substance and style, did elevate Christian's message and kind of point out some of the vulnerabilities of Sarah's.
Yeah, I didn't see that at all. I thought, listen, clearly he's a man of great conviction and passion and believes strongly, and I think did articulate a central message of wanting of hope and healing and peace, and I thought that was impressive. But at the end of the day, I just don't see him getting. I do not see the Libertarian Party getting to 3%. I think this all really boils down to the R and the D, and that's where all the heat's going to be. And it could, you know.
4 years ago, Libertarian candidate got just right under 3%. So I think it's doable in this election cycle. I'm not saying it'll happen, but I think it's doable. So, all right, let's talk about, there were a week's worth of other debates this last week. We don't have time to go into all of them because we're at about 2.5 minutes left for this segment. Just for each of you, Megan, I'll come to you first on this. Just point out, was there any one of the particular debates that you saw something special, unique, or disastrous, however you want to describe it? So a standout moment, I suppose.
Sure, I could talk about a few. I think there were some strong moments for Democrats this week with the debates. Two that come to mind specifically were Kelly Kraut and Annabeth Gorman in their respective debates. I think that in both instances, they really communicated kind of a fresh message and bringing in an experience to the role that is different from what Arkansans have seen, and found ways to really elevate and connect that message to voters in a new way. I think we've seen Kelly Kraut, you know, be able to really engage with voters in a very accessible way, bring politics to voters who may not have been engaged previously. And I also thought she did a good job in kind of calling out some of Leslie Rutledge's nonsense. I appreciate her boldness there. I think with Annabeth Gorman, similarly, her experience in being a chief executive and also kind of reimagining the role as an opportunity advocate, I love her framing there. And think it was a good way to kind of communicate what these state level positions can be and should be, and engage voters in a new way.
Bill just wants to be in one of Kelly's TikToks.
Yeah, well, listen, it's going to be a big year for Republicans. And from a pure political standpoint, every Republican that took the stage had really everything to lose and nothing to gain, because there are wide margins in every race. I think it's clear that Tim Griffin's the next attorney general. Leslie Rutledge is the next lieutenant governor. I think Mark Lowry has the race sewn up. So there's just not a lot that can be generated by Republicans from these debates. And let me go a step further. People that watch debates now have their minds made up anyway. The real message is they've become material for social media. That's where the real elevation of the debate occurs now. And I say that theoretically, not actually, because you see a lot of this stuff that's used on Twitter and Instagram and other social media communications, Facebook, that comes out of the debate. So that's where people really see what goes on, not the actual debate itself.
And that's where you don't want to make a mistake if you're a candidate. All right, we got to wrap it up here. Representative Megan Godfrey, Democrat of Springdale, Bill Vickery, GOP strategist and political consultant. Thank you both for your insight. Appreciate you.
Thank you.
All right, we're back with more right after this.